All right, I'm gonna be showing you how to factor out a monomial from two different trinomials. So think of these as two completely different problems. I think it's important that you see one from each because this one has a little something different with it. Pay attention, stay around to the end of the video so that you know the difference between the two. All right, so first and foremost, factoring out basically the reverse or the undoing of the multiplication. So I need to pull a monomial out from this 1, 2, 3-termed trinomial. We're gonna start by finding the greatest common factor. What is the greatest common factor between 4, 24, and 8? They're all divisible by 4, so I'm gonna pull 4 out. And then I have to ask myself, do each of the terms have an x? Yes, yes, and yes. They all have at least how many? The easy way to figure this out is go to the lowest one, x to the fifth, x to the third, x all alone. They all have at least one x, so I can pull x out as well. And then I'm just gonna put empty parentheses and I'm gonna kind of work backwards through the distributive property. So if I was taking 4x and multiplying it by three different terms, I would end up getting this. We have to ask ourselves, 4x times what makes 4x to the fifth power? Well, that would just be x to the fourth power. Now I'm gonna say 4x times what would make negative, boom, right there, that should stand out to you. A positive times a what would make a negative. We know it's gotta be a negative answer. 4 times what makes 24? 6. X times what makes x to the third? We would have to say x squared. 2 plus 1 would make the 3. And last but not least, 4x times what makes positive 8x? 4x times 2. You have now factored out a monomial, the monomial being the 4x. We factored that out from the trinomial. Okay, so that's your first example. Now let's take a peek at the second example where we have something slightly different. Here, each of the terms had an x. Here we have an n, and we do not have an n on the end. So all we're gonna really pull out, the monomial that we pull out of this trinomial is just gonna be a basic number, okay? It's just gonna be a constant. 14, 35, 28, it should almost stand out right away to you. What are they all divisible by? 7. We're not pulling out n because if we pulled out an n, we would be multiplying it by this last term and we would have an n attached. We don't have that in this case, so 7 times what makes 14 n to the third power? 7 times what makes 14? 2 n to the third power. 7 times what makes negative 35? Negative 5. 7, we need to multiply it by an n squared. And then 7 times what would make a positive 28? And we know that's going to be 4. Okay. Factoring out a monomial. 1, 2, 3 terms. Trinomial, we factored out a single term. We factored out a single term. Hopefully this makes sense. Study hard and good luck on your upcoming test.